In this tutorial, let's see some slides related to text editing in HTML. So here, the bold text is there, italic text is there, and the underline text is there. So these are the different ways of highlighting the text. So in HTML, there are texts for highlighting the text using bold, italic, and underline. So these are the different texts: bold, italic, and underline. So for bold it's B, for italic it's I, and for underline it's U. So B is used to display bold text, I is used to display italic text, and U is used to display the underline text. So to give an underline, you can use the U text. For bold and italic, we can use the following text: strong text strong. So it's strong text strong for bold, EM text for italic. So these are the different texts also which can be used for bold and italic. The strong is there for bold and EM is there for italic. Now the next slide. Now making paragraphs and separating the chunks of text. So how you can make the different paragraphs. Okay. And when you use different paragraph, then you will get a line gap between the two paragraphs. So this is one of the advantages of using a paragraph text. So we can write text in paragraphs using the following text. So P, this paragraph. So means P tag is used for writing a paragraph. Okay. We can separate chunks of text using the following text like P text P. So using different P tags, you can separate different paragraphs. So now next slide. To give a gap between a paragraph, we can use the BR tag. So for different, to give a gap between two paragraphs, we can also use the BR tag. The gap between the two paragraphs is 3 lines. The tag used for this is, so you can use, this is a simple example. So we are using this paragraph. So here break means changing the new line. This again break is changing to the new line. Okay. But here you can see the gap is not there between two lines. But if we use a paragraph, then you can see a small gap, a line gap is there between two paragraphs. But in BR, the line gap is not there. So this is the main difference between the paragraph and a P, is that BR is a empty element and P is a container element. Okay. So empty element is got only starting tag, and P there we have a starting tag and an ending tag. So therefore have both, it is a starting tag and ending tag. So therefore it is a container tag. Now next. So HR with, so HR is used to make a horizontal rule. Okay. So to make, to give a underline. So to separate a web page into different, into two sections, you can use the AR tag, HR tag. So HR tag is used to give a line. So for example, HR width. So these are the different, this is the attribute of this HR tag. So HR width is equal to 80% means 80% of the whole web page. Or HR width is equal to 40%, so 40% of the whole web page. Or HR size is equal to 5, the size means what is the size of this line. Okay, so that much for this tutorial. We will see some more editing slides in the next tutorial.